Welcome, everybody, to Vape Radio, your source for everything you want to know about the business of vaping. Whether you're a brick-and-mortar location, developer of e-liquids, online marketer, or anything else in the vape space, this is the place to be. Learn from the first and the largest educational providers in the country with your host and founder of Vape Mentors, Mr. Norm Bauer. Hey, Norm.
Hey, Paul. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to Vape Radio. I know it's been a little bit of a while. Here it is, July. This is show number 57. We're knocking on the door of number 6, and you know what? Today is a very special day because we're actually going to be knocking out 4 segments today. And the reason is because there's that much really amazing and good stuff to share with you today. And we also have a brand new advertiser I want to introduce you to, and it's probably someone that you might be familiar with, but you might not know their name. We want to welcome the Council of Vapor to our radio show. You've probably not heard of the Council of Vapor, but guaranteed you will. If you have a concept for a mod or a pen of any style, these are the pros to speak with. They recreate sleek, high-quality vaping hardware and will help you with your design, prototype, and manufacturing. They already produce some of the top sellers out there, including the Royal Hunter, and you guys know what that is, and the Kindred lines, and they create only high-quality products. But that's just the beginning. They just opened one of the largest e-liquid production centers in the country with over 50,000 square feet under one roof. I was there a few weeks ago, and they're already manufacturing some of the top names in the industry. And you know what? They want to work with you. They'll help you with your hardware or e-liquid needs no matter what size company. And if you want to learn more, just go to thecouncilofvapor.com. They're rolling out a brand new line called Osmos. That's O-Z-M-O-S with 8 new flavors ranging from sweet desserts to cocktail juices. What's so special and different about them? Well, you know, they're willing to show you. And if you contact them and mention Vape Radio, they're going to send you an exclusive sample pack of all 8 flavors. Once again, that website is thecouncilofvapor.com. So we certainly want to welcome that organization to the Vape Radio show. So as I said, we're actually going to be recording 4 shows today. And the reason is we have an amazing interview with one of the true masters of vape. His name is Austin Hopper. You might not know his name either, but if you've been to any vaping events in the past 2 years, you probably know the guy on stage who's shooting t-shirts out of a cannon, giving away products, or maybe he's emceeing cloud contests. He does it all. He's launching his brand new e-liquid company, and you are going to hear it first right here on Vape Radio, so do not go away because that interview is coming up. We also have an interview on something that you maybe not want to talk about, but you need to know about, and that's insurance. If you're in the vape space, you have a liability, guys, whether you know about it or whether you prepare for it or not. This interview is one of the heads of Calco Insurance, the man who goes by one name. His name is Sarkis, and he has some amazing things to share. Actually, we went a little bit long on the interview because I was so enthralled with everything he was sharing. So let's talk about some of the things that have happening over the most recent past. One is, for those of you who have brick-and-mortar stores, I want to kind of give you a cautionary note. There's some dangers out there, and it's in the form of break-ins. You know, here we worry about the FDA and the state, and we worry about the city, but, you know, there's been a preponderance of break-ins at vape shops. So I want to make sure that you guys have a top-notch security system, and it's not just a coincidence that today's show is about insurance and about liability, but, you know, the reality of it is that you need a high-quality security system and an internal camera. I've been reading about break-ins in L.A., Denver, Portland, Charlotte, you know, big cities, small cities, just a few of the names that are out there. So, again, we want you to be safe out there. So if you have a vape shop, please make sure you secure it. Make sure you use high quality, top-of-the-line type of security system and monitor what's going on. I want to share with you an event that's going to be coming up soon, and hopefully you're going to be hearing this in time because the event is coming up in August 13th through 16th in Pomona. It's known as ECC, that's the Electronic Cigarette Convention. Last year when I was out there, that was year number 2, had about 25,000 people over several days, and it was a behemoth of an operation. This year it's going to be in Pomona at the Los Angeles Fairplex, which is where the LA Fair and the horse track is there as well. Between now and the end of the year, I don't care where you are in the United States, there will be an event somewhere close to you because we've got 24 that are on slate through Vape Magazine, and there's something everywhere, including the most recent fiasco in New Jersey. It was called Vape Expo NJ, Vape Expo New Jersey. And you might have heard about it because it was all over Twitter. It was all over Instagram. And it seems like the health department came in to this several-day event, and they ordered the vaping to stop or face a $250 fine. Okay, so that's a little bit of a disconnect there. You go to a vaping convention or a vaping fest, and you try to go in, and you're not allowed to vape. That just doesn't work. So day number one was okay. Day number two, some of the people were ordered outside if they wanted to vape, and the regulator said that you can vape if you only use it to sample 0 milligram liquids, which, of course, is preposterous. So let's just say there was about 1,200 generally pissed off vendors there and a lot of members of the public who they basically walked away, because if you can't enjoy yourself undisturbed, if you can't enjoy yourself and participate in the events, then it's just not going to be any fun. So here's the question. Who is at fault? Was it the over-anxious regulators and agencies? Was the promoter remiss in getting the right permits? You know, the answers are unclear. We're still not 100% sure exactly, you know, where the buck stopped. But after speaking to several people who were at the event, it seems that the proper approval was not granted. It seems like there was some paperwork that was missing. So right now, unless I hear different, it seems to fall on the responsibility of the promoter. But again, we're going to keep digging about it and then kind of going from there. Here's another piece of unfortunate news. For those of you who are familiar with crowdfunding sites like Kickstarter and Indiegogo, there was a vaping product that was put on there. It was a vaporizer called Xolo, spelled X-O-L-O. And these folks had this device on the market, created a really beautiful video. It was a really nice-looking box mod. And come to find out that the brilliant people at Indiegogo decided that this was a drug delivery device, and so they pulled it off of their website. So the reality of it is that there's way too many knee-jerk reactions out there from all kinds of people who really do not need to, or should they not discriminate about our industry, but yet they do. So again, this is, you know, not to keep on a run of bad news here, but I'm going to continue on because there's some bad stuff that really came out of Indiana, and you might have heard about it. It's officially known as Indiana Bill Number 1432, and the question is it a sign of things to come? And what it is, it's a mess of restrictions. They passed a bill, and here's what the bill does not allow you to do. It does not allow you to manufacture e-liquids or sell e-liquids unless you have a permit from the Alcohol and Tobacco Commission. I'm not quite clear whether that just means a regular tobacco seller's license or whether there's more to it than that. I need to do a little bit of research. All the manufacturers within the state of Indiana, if they are making e-liquid, they have to have 24-hour video surveillance anywhere it's mixed, packaged, bottled, or stored. So again, we're talking about a little bit of a theme today. The little bit of theme is cover your ass, because there's a lot of things that are going down that you have to be very wary of, because there's people looking over your shoulder. All the more reasons why you need to be doing things professionally. These people who are manufacturing in the state of Indiana, they pay an application fee of $1,000, and they're going to renew to the tune of $500 every 5 years. And also, you cannot have any felonies if you are a principal in a manufacturing agency. Oh, and here's the good news, guys. This even applies if you are out of state. So if you're a California or a New York or a Florida company, those are three of the biggies, and you try to sell your e-liquids in Indiana, you're going to have to abide by the same regulations and laws, which as far as I'm concerned, this is a bunch of bullshit. This is just unreasonable. It's absolutely ridiculous. And the reality is lawsuits are already being filed, calling it unconstitutional. And since it does not take effect until next July, that's July 2016, I personally, again, this is one person's opinion, I think the bill is going to be struck down. I don't think the bill has sustainability, and I do believe that you're going to see regulators having to back down. And, of course, once the FDA comes in with their brand new deeming regs, which should be happening this year, then, of course, they're going to override and supersede any type of state restrictions. You know, I know about this personally because I have two shops that I'm involved with within the state of Indiana. And, of course, they were a little bit concerned, you know, maybe justifiably so, maybe not. And I told them just to kind of chill out and not really do anything from the permit department until January of next year, because that'll still give them 6 months to do it. All right, so let's go on to some more positive, better news. Big increase of e-liquid companies. Since we spoke last, it's been a little while. I've been to three different events, and again, the e-liquid manufacturers out there are growing exponentially, literally like mushrooms. And so, you know, what we are doing here at Vape Mentors, we are actually creating a turnkey program to help you create your own line. Specifically, if you have a brick and mortar store. If you have a brick and mortar store and you'd like to have your own line, and based on the numbers I've seen, it's somewhere between about 55 and 60% of the brick and mortar locations have their own line. We have basically a turnkey solution, and we're working with some of the top names in the industry to kind of create flavors that are dialed in exactly to you and your marketplace. So, you know, you can let us know here at vapementors.com or give us a call at on our website, and we'll go ahead and take care of you with that. And along the lines of people and different people creating lines of e-liquids, we're also seeing another trend, and that is musicians creating their own products. Of course, you heard about Snoop Dogg and his hardware line, and my producer Paul actually gave me a little bit of information on that earlier today. And this, of course, has been out for a while, but there's two musical groups that I'm aware of that actually created their own lines of e-liquid. One of them is called Guar, that's G-W-A-R, and the other one is called Saliva. And as it turns out, both of them are going to be previewed in our next vape magazine, which will be coming out in October. I actually spoke with one of the leads from the Saliva group and talked about, you know, what their motivation was behind it. And to be honest with you, I think it's an absolutely brilliant idea. You know, for those of you who are out there in the e-liquid industry, or you want to get into the e-liquid industry, if you have name recognition, that is a huge, huge advantage, which is one of the reasons why you're really going to enjoy the interview that's going to be coming up in the following segments. You know, we're interviewing Austin Hopper. Austin has an amazing pedigree. He's been with Cutwood. He's been with Space Jam. He's been with Cosmic Fog. He was their marketing guy, and he is a CFO, and he's done a lot of different things. So the guy is extraordinarily well-connected, well-respected. You know, anytime he posts anything on Instagram or Facebook, he gets lots and lots and lots of viewers. And so Austin has actually created his own company. I'm not going to tell you what it is. You're going to have to listen to that. But it has a most interesting story about where the name came from, because it's a five-letter word. And I said, well, so where did the name came from? And he told me, and we just had a good time with that. He got all red and embarrassed, and you're going to have to stick around if you want to hear that. As to Vape Radio here, we hit a milestone, and for those of you who have been loyal listeners, for those of you who are new listeners, for those of you who, you know, like what we do, I just want to thank you very sincerely. We passed 520,000 downloads. We crossed a 500,000 mark over the last 30 days or so, and that was over a 14-month period. We had a few months there where we had a glitch in our system and the downloads were not coming fast and furious, but right now we're hitting 2,000 plus downloads per day, and I'm very, very pleased at that. And so here's our goal, and we would want your help. We ask for your help. We want to break through 60,000 downloads during this month of August. So if you are listening to this during the month of August 2015, please rate our show on iTunes or Stitcher or Podbean or wherever you're listening, and also share it with anyone that you know, because we came really, really close to hitting 60,000 downloads in two different months, but we missed it by a few hundred. So August is the month, guys, and so if we continue our run of 2,000 downloads per month, we would be able to hit that. And here's my lofty goal. I want to be at 1 million by the end of the year. It's not going to happen by myself. It's going to happen with your support. And if you can give us a hand by sharing Vape Radio with your friends, absolutely post the media player and kind of share it with anyone and everyone you know. So here's some interesting statistics, because, again, I follow statistics, especially about, you know, our listeners and our followers. Far and away, our biggest audience is in the United States, which continues to hover somewhere around 75-76% of the people. Next is the UK, England, and just so happens that I'm going to start writing some articles for a brand new magazine over there called Vape Around, or as they call it over there, Vape Around. That's my brogue accent, which kind of didn't work. So I'm going to be working with some UK publishers over there. And next on the list, not very far behind, is Canada. The vaping industry is very, very healthy in Canada. But for American manufacturers, unfortunately, it's very difficult to sell your e-liquids up there because they have very severe nicotine restrictions. Now, here's one that's on the radar that maybe will surprise you. It did surprise me, and that's Russia. The Russian Federation now is becoming a lot more commercialized, a lot more capitalistic. And, you know, when the fall of the Berlin Wall happened several decades ago, it took a long time for it to kind of trickle down to the masses. There's been, of course, some major money made through oil, through a lot of the tyrants and the dictators over there. And it really hasn't drilled down to the average person. But what we're seeing is that a big growth in the Russian Federation as far as our downloads. Again, I'm not quite sure how big the e-cig industry is over there, but what I do know is they had their first convention this past fall of 2016. They contacted me and asked me to speak, and I decided that it was probably not the best thing for me to do at that time, but I'm monitoring the market over there in Russia, and certainly I'm monitoring the market over there in China. Not just from a manufacturing standpoint, but from a usage standpoint as well. And here is what is missing. Presumably, we're winding down the war in Afghanistan. We're winding down our presence over there in the Middle East. And, you know, you've heard me mention before that we had a significant population from Afghanistan that was listening to vape radio. And that has dropped off significantly. So I'm hoping that means our boys are home or they're somewhere else. And, you know, we support them and thank them for everything they've done over there. And you know what else is missing? There's virtually no presence in the Middle East. And that's not because of us. That's because of the unreasonableness of the people out there. The reality of it is, guys, is that unfortunately there's a lot of countries that are just not willing to acknowledge that vaping is not cigarettes, it is not tobacco, and so the problem has been is that they are throwing everyone into the exact same category, and it sucks. That's really all there is to it. And so the bottom line is that we have to make sure that we advocate, get involved with all of your agencies, and just kind of do the right thing, you know, be good harbingers of the industry and make sure that you, if you're in the vape shop, just treat people with fairness, educate people as best you can. So that is my lesson for today. That is my little soapbox tirade. So again, just be good harbingers of the industry out there. Do the right thing. If you are in the brick and mortar space, just make sure you treat your people with fairness, with kindness, and with education. And we're coming down to the end of the segment. So you want to go ahead and give me some outro music there, brother?
You got it. You've been listening to Vape Radio. Stick around, a lot more to come.